Tokyo's name was inspired by a t-shirt? Which city name does the professor have? Because he does have a name. How different could the cast have been? And what is the secret behind making the kissing scene between Tokyo and Rio look that passionate? Are they dating in real life? Hi, I'm Clive, you're watching Asa, and let's talk about all the secrets of making Money Heist. And beware of spoilers, there are gonna be some. The show was a failure. It may be hard to imagine, but back in 2017, La Casa de Papel didn't show promising results at all. Maybe the first episode did with its 4.5 million viewers on the local Spanish channel, but the longer the show went on, the less people watched it. By the end of season 1, viewership had dropped by 3 times its initial number. Seeing that, the team of La Casa de Papel was 100% sure that it was the end of the show. Everybody from the cast and crew were really upset. But then Netflix came in and changed everything. They bought the series, and they also made several important changes, starting from retitling the show, so its translation, House of Papers, wouldn't be so similar to House of Cards. The result was a huge increase of viewers from all over the world. Soon after the show went international, the actors had to deal with another crazy fact. They became insanely popular. When the cast of Money Heist checked their Instagram pages, which barely had any followers before, they got such a fright. They were getting thousands of new followers every hour. More than that, the new fans of the show started to make tattoos with the Money Heist characters' faces, and imitated the way the characters dressed in the series. Yes, we're talking about wearing those red suits and putting on those Dolly masks. Even Stephen King, Karim Benzema, Neymar, and many more celebs tried the mask on too. As the series made it to second place on IMDb's most popular shows, it became obvious. Money Heist was an absolute worldwide hit, and its journey had only just started. We'll briefly interrupt this video to say that it was sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. It's an all-new original RPG game with an awesome storyline, fantastic 3D graphics, cool PvP modes, and tons of different badass champions and heroes to collect. And it's absolutely free! We know, our channel is all about celebs and series and movies, but I've been playing Raid for a couple of days now and I'm already hooked. It has well-thought-out characters, crazy storylines, and a tremendous amount of different monsters and creatures to fight against. And it's available on both PC and mobile. And just for now, the daily login rewards program for new players has been doubled from 90 to 180 days. Crazy, right? Every day, you can claim your free rewards, from energy refills, silver and gems to shards and a free barbarian legendary champion, Skill of the Drake. So, what are you waiting for? Go to the video description, click on the special links, and if you're a new player, you will get 200,000 silver. And silver is what you use to upgrade your champions, plus one free awesome champion, Grinner. Look how cute he is! From what I understand, Grinner is an unbelievably useful champion in the game who can really help you out with your progress during the first few months of playing. All of these awards will be waiting for you here for the next 30 days. Go check it out! Writing and filming at the same time. Here's a crazy fact. Unlike most TV series where the writing process happens long before shooting, Money Heist is a true exception. It was basically being written at the same time it was being filmed. Believe it or not, but most of the crew didn't know exactly what was going to happen in the episode before they filmed it the next day. Everything was rewritten constantly. How did the whole process even work? The same can be said for the title of the show, which was originally called Los Desahuciados, which means evicted, but sometime later it was changed to La Casa de Papel. The thing was that the crew used drafts to film with, and most of the scenes and dialogues were written in those drafts. But as crazy as it seems, the showrunners loved it when everybody was kept on their toes. According to them, this process allows for something new and original to be created, and the writing team can use the material and evolve the scene right away. Well, as weird as it sounds, it definitely worked. Why the name Tokyo? No doubt, you can't name another series or a movie that uses the same trick with the character names. Tarantino used colors for his movie Reservoir Dogs, and the movie Emperor of the North, made in 1973, surprised us with unique character names like Cigarette and Number One. But in our opinion, Money Heist went even further than that. They used city names. Believe it or not, the idea to call characters by a city name came to the showrunners because of a t-shirt. Crazy, right? One of the series creators, Alex Pina, once wore a t-shirt with the word Tokyo on it, which inspired the creators to use city names as characters' names. Berlin, Moscow, Denver, Rio. The rest of the names started to pop up in the showrunners' heads one by one after they saw the Tokyo t-shirt. This is another great example of how the creative process worked for the Money Heist team. And by the way, did you know that the professor also has a city name? Not an official one, but still. According to Alvaro Morte, he came up with the perfect city name for his character. Any ideas what it is? Try to guess. It's a small city, very old and important for world culture. Okay, we'll tell you. Here's what Alvaro Morte says. The concept of what it is fits him, but we have to remove the religious components. This would be Vatican City. It's a state city, a very small one. But like the professor, it's always shielded. And at the same time, it has a great power all over the world, Morte said. Cool, isn't it? Though the actor Jamie Lorente, who plays Denver, would rather disagree with this statement. I would call him Professor Venice Beach, just because that would be amazing. Well, the actors of La Casa de Papel definitely have a sense of humor. Before we move on to that kissing scene between Tokyo and Rio, let's firstly talk about another crucial element of Money Heist. Casting could have changed everything. Can you imagine Salva as a 50-year-old Harvard professor type? If you can't, then look at this photo of Jose Coronado. That was who the showrunners were looking for. But as the character developed on the page, it became more and more obvious that they needed someone younger, shy, and more empathetic. That's why casting directors insisted on actor Alvaro Morte, who they'd already worked with on the long-running soap opera project. Despite the casting director's recommendation, it took a really long time before Alvaro became part of the team. How long exactly? 2.5 months. Pretty long, right? I did 5 auditions for this role, said Morte. My first audition, I said, okay, it's a heist, it's Spain, so they're going to want to make a copy of Ocean's 11. And so they must want George Clooney. My first audition was all self-confidence. They called me, said they liked it very much, but they wanted a freaky side to this guy. I said, freaky what? The reason why it took so long for producers to accept Morte is that they didn't really know from the beginning what they wanted from his character. As time went by, they realized that they were looking for a man with many faces. Like Superman, who hides his original personality. He's the professor, he's Salva, and he's Sergio at the same time. Freaky! As Morte realized what the showrunners were looking for, he was able to come with his own vision for the character. And thank God they liked it. If that's enough to make nerds in the world feel a little bit like heroes, I'm really happy with that, Alvaro joked. What about casting for Tokyo? Was it an easy choice for the producers? Oh, hell no! Similar to the professor situation, the showrunners wanted a much older actress for Tokyo. They imagined her as a woman who has absolutely nothing to lose, and that's why she agreed to join the professor's team. But then Ursula Corbero came in and changed the game drastically. Any ideas what exactly helped her to get the part? Try remembering the very beginning of Money Heist. What do you see or even hear first? That's right, Tokyo's voice.
Me llamo Tokyo. Pero cuando comenzó esta historia, no me llamaba así.
It soon became obvious that her voice was the key element for building the character, and Ursula was meant to play that part. And here is a little surprise fact for you. Do you guys think it's just the producers and screenwriters who develop the characters and the unexpected twists around them? Well, you're wrong! The actor who played Berlin, Pedro Alonso, had some great input too, along with Alvaro Morte. Were you surprised by the family connections between the professor and Berlin? Sure you were! Then you should definitely know that it was originally Pedro Alonso's idea to include this in the script. But it wasn't easy to convince the showrunners to do so. It was just his persistence in proposing the same crazy idea that made it finally come to life in the show. Seems like Pedro is sly and skillful in achieving his goals, just like Berlin is. Tokyo and Rio's kissing scene. How could anyone look that passionate while performing a kissing scene? We've watched Tokyo and Rio's love story from the very first episode, and admit it, they are very convincing at portraying lovers. So, maybe the actors who play them are partners in real life? No, they're not. There are 2 secrets to making such scenes look realistic. Reason number 1, great directions from the show creator, and many, many, many takes to make things look right. Though we at ASA believe that the most important reason is the second one. Spanish actors are truly passionate. You can see it in every episode, and even in the way the drama develops for different characters. And of course, when it comes to portraying a convincing on-screen love couple, there's no other nation in the world that can do it better than the kings of soap operas. The creator of Money Heist paid a lot of attention to the romantic scenes. For a long time, there was an unwritten rule that action movies were empty and superficial, and dramas were boring. So what we did was mix those 2 concepts, said Alex Pena in his interview for the Netflix documentary. What do you guys think? Did the creators of Money Heist do a good job mixing 2 genres? And did you know any of these behind-the-scenes details before? Share with us in the comments below! And for now, thanks for staying safe and awesome!